So let us solve this problem. Show that 1 plus tan square a divided by 1 plus cot square a is equal to 1 minus tan a divided by 1 minus cot a whole square is equal to tan square a. Okay. So 1 plus tan square a divided by 1 plus cot square a. Okay. We have studied an identity that secant square a minus tan square a is equal to 1, or secant square theta minus tan square theta is equal to 1, right? So if tan goes on the other side, secant square a will be 1 plus tan square a. So in the numerator, can we write secant square a here? Yes, so this is secant square a divided by, and there is one more identity, cosecant square a minus cot square a is equal to 1. So if cot goes on the other side, cosecant square a will be 1 plus cot square a, right? So in place of 1 plus cot square a, we can write cosecant square a, cosecant square a. Okay, this thing. All right, now secant square a, how can we write secant? It is 1 by cos square a, right, into cosecant. How can we write cosecant? 1 by sine square a, isn't it? So this secant, this sine goes to the numerator, it becomes sine square a divided by cos square a. What is sine by cos? It is equal to tan. We have a square, so it is tan square a. Okay, so 1 plus tan square a divided by 1 plus cot square a is equal to tan square a. Okay, so half of the problem is done, right? So now we need to prove that this part is equal to tan square a. Let us solve that. We have 1 minus tan a divided by 1 minus cot a whole square. We should prove that this is equal to tan square a. Okay. All right. Now, how can we write tan? 1 minus tan is sine by cos divided by 1 minus cot is cos by sine, isn't it? Whole square. Now divided by 1 here. So let us simplify the numerator. 1 into cos, cos. 1 into cos is cos minus 1 into sine is sine, whole divided by 1 into sine, sine. 1 into sine, sine minus 1 into cos, cos. This is whole squared. Okay. Now we have division of division. Alright. Division of division. So this will become cos a minus sine a divided by cos a multiplied by, this becomes reciprocal, right? So it is sine a divided by sine a minus cos a whole square. Okay, see, we needed tan square a. We should get this as tan square a. We have the answer here. See, sine divided by cos is tan, so we have a square. So tan square a will get, but this term should not be there, right? So we should cancel this term. But how can we cancel? Here we have plus cos a minus sine a plus sine a. The signs are different, isn't it? So what we should do here is we should take minus out. If you take minus out here, let us say we are taking minus out in this term. You can take minus out in this term also. So this will become minus cos a plus sine a. Okay, see, if you are having doubts, just multiply this. Minus into minus will become plus, minus into plus will become minus, right? And we have sine by cos, so it is sine divided by cos multiplied by sine minus cos a. Here this is whole square. Okay, it is like this, right? Now let us rewrite this term again. What is it? It is sine a minus cos a outside the brackets minus into sine a by cos A multiplied by sin A minus cos A whole squared. So this term and this term is same now, right? It will become zero. It will get cancelled, sorry. So now what is left? We have minus sin A divided by cos A whole square. Minus square is plus only, right? So sin square divided by cos. Sin divided by cos is how much? Tan. So it is tan square A because we have a square here. Okay. So therefore, what do we have here? 1 plus tan square A divided by 1 plus cot square A. This is equal to 1 minus tan A divided by 1 minus cot A whole square is equal to tan square A.